So, dear ones, understand that what we have described for you today is merely a dissection of this permanent moment, this experience that always remains with us. And within this experience, we have change and we have permanence. And within this experience, we have emptiness and fullness. We have vibration and we have silence. Within all of this, dear one, is you. Containing all of this is you. For you give yourself experience by being the permanence and seeing the change. You give yourself experience by being the silence and creating the vibration within you. Can you understand this, dear ones? You are that which has come before form, and that which has come before formlessness. You are greater than both, so do not limit yourself to identification with any one of these. Do not seek a sense of self within the world of form, for the world of form is always changing. And do not seek a sense of self in the world of formlessness, in the formless consciousness, the formless witnessing state, for this is empty and devoid of you. Instead, dear one, simply understand and accept that you are both of these, and give up the desire to cling to any definition of who you are. This, dear ones, is the basis of your confusion. This, dear ones, is the cause of your suffering. The mind continually seeks identification with some experience. It desires to know itself in a temporary world which has no permanence. And it desires to know itself in a world of form that cannot at all be called real. And yet, dear one, in this search to better know yourself, you come to the understanding that you are the formless consciousness, and the mind clings to this reality, pushing away the world of form, calling the world of form wrong, believing that it must escape from this samsaric experience that exists all around it. And yet, dear one, the mind continues to split apart that which is. The mind continues to judge the current experience of this moment, believing that part of it is true and part of it is false, that part of it is good and part of it is bad. So, dear ones, instead of creating this conflict within your mind, instead of believing yourself to be secure because you have grasped and clung onto materialistic possessions of a changing world, or because you have grasped and clung onto the belief that you are not real, the belief that you are the empty witness, the belief that the world of form cannot touch you. Instead, dear one, simply let go. Simply give up your idea that you are limited in any such way. Realize that form and formlessness co-create each other. Realize that being as the permanent sense of self, being as the consciousness and the emptiness, will free you from suffering caused from identification with the world of form. But do not desire to push away the world of form. Do not desire to cling to your emptiness, or you will not fully realize that you are both, that you are all that is, that you are all possibility, that you are this moment in its totality. This, dear one, may be a difficult concept and understanding to comprehend, but simply give up. Simply give up the search to find yourself and learn to be this moment, and you will be progressing towards this spiritual realization. Do not cling to an identity of forms. Do not cling to an identity of formlessness. But instead, dear one, simply allow yourself to be and become more aware, become more awake. We guide you, dear ones, not to change yourself, not to create a new identification of yourself, but instead to free yourself. To free yourself by being yourself. Not the self that your mind believes to be true, but the awareness, the being, the peacefulness, understand how the mind functions, understand how the emotions move, understand how the physical body works within this world, by being with it, by being one with the experience. And then, dear ones, you will learn to allow, learn to trust the natural intelligence that exists within every moment, the natural intelligence that guides the function of your body, that guides the function of your mind. You will learn, dear one, to trust and understand the greater intelligence that exists in you and beyond you as a manifest being. For this intelligence is one and the same as yourself. It is the intelligence that is governing all form and all manifestation. And as you learn to understand this, and as you surrender more deeply into this, you will find peace, and you will find love. You will find oneness. So, dear ones, we encourage you to find more of that which you are by embracing all of life, by using your awareness, by using your mind to better understand that which you perceive. Come to know all layers of yourself, the manifest and the unmanifest, and learn to be with both in this eternal moment. Many blessings, dear ones, and namaste.